Hi everyone. In this video lecture, we will be discussing about how to identify various types of tympanograms. This lecture will be a basic guide for second year BASLP students. At the end of this video lecture, the students will be able to understand the basic concepts of tympanometry in terms of purpose, procedure, and the tympanogram graph. They will also be able to identify different types of tympanograms, voice type A tympanogram, type B and type C tympanograms. They will also be able to delineate the clinical applications of various tympanograms. Tympanometry is a procedure, also an objective test of medullary function. This evaluates the mobility of the tympanic membrane by varying the air pressure in the ear canal. Tympanogram is a graphical representation of the tympanic membrane's vibration with respect to the changes in the air pressure in the ear canal. This is a graphical representation of a tympanogram where the graph is plotted against x-axis and y-axis. X-axis has the values in decapascal, which mentions the pressure of the middle ear. The y-axis measures the movement of the tympanic membrane as complaints of the tympanic membrane. Its unit is cubic centimeter or milliliter. The purpose of performing tympanometry is to assess the middle ear function. This procedure will help us to identify the fluid presence in the middle ear, perforation of the tympanic membrane or eustachian tube dysfunction. It is performed by placing a probe in the ear canal, which will emit sounds and varies the air pressure to measure the responses of the tympanic membrane. The probe assembly is not discussed in this particular lecture. It will be discussed in some other video lecture. With respect to types of tympanograms, there are several types of tympanograms, each type indicating different conditions of the middle ear. The most common types of tympanograms are type A, type B, and type C. Type A tympanogram indicates that tympanic membrane compliance is normal with normal middle ear pressure. It is characterized by normal ear canal volume and normal compliance of the tympanic membrane. So the peak of the tympanic membrane varies somewhere between minus 100 to plus 100 dapa or decapascals, and the compliance of the tympanic membrane varies between 0.3 milliliter to 1.5 milliliter. A normal tympanic membrane or the tympanogram, type A tympanogram, looks like shown in the figure. Type AS tympanogram. This indicates a shallow or stiff compliance of the tympanic membrane or restricted movement of the tympanic membrane. This is characterized by reduced height of the tympanogram. However, the middle ear pressure will be within normal range. It indicates otosclerosis or tympanosclerosis, sometimes even thicker tympanic membrane, which is not vibrating to the normal range. AD type tympanogram indicates the compliance of the tympanic membrane is higher, or the tympanic membrane is hypermobile in nature. It is characterized by increased peak height, but the middle ear pressure is within normal limits. It indicates that there is ossicular chain discontinuity, or the tympanic membrane is flaccid or thin, or sometimes it may also indicate the tympanic membrane has a healed perforation. Type B tympanogram indicates a flat tympanogram without any peak. So there will be virtually no compliance or peak pressure. It indicates middle ear effusion, perforation or impacted cerumen. The B-type tympanogram can be differentiated with the help of ear canal volume. When the ear canal volume is normal, then the B-type tympanogram suggests there is middle ear effusion. If the ear canal volume is extremely large, then there is a perforation of the tympanic membrane. Hence, the ear canal volume is measured with ear canal as well as the middle ear volume. Hence, there is an increased ear canal volume. A flat tympanogram with reduced ear canal volume indicates there is impacted cerumen. At times, when the probe is placed against the ear canal wall, also we will get similar type of tympanogram. C-type tympanogram will have negative middle ear pressure. Hence, the peak will be shifted towards the negative pressure. It is characterized by a peak complaints occurring at the negative pressure beyond minus 100 decapascals. The complaints of the tympanic membrane can be normal or it might be reduced due to the restricted movement of the tympanic membrane because of the negative pressure. It indicates that a person is having eustachian tube dysfunction or the otitis media is at the beginning stages or in the resolving stage. Moving on to clinical applications of tympanometry. Tympanometry acts as a valuable tool in diagnosing and managing various middle ear conditions. Especially, it is used as a valid or viable tool, screening tool for middle ear disorders, especially in children. It can be included in routine part of audiological evaluations to understand the middle ear function. It can be used to monitor chronic ear problems, how the middle ear disorder is developing over a period of time, or after medication, how the middle ear condition is resolving over a period of time. These changes can be tracked using tympanometry. Tympanometric procedures can also be performed before surgery and after surgery to say that the impact of middle ear condition before surgery and post surgery, how the person is getting benefited from the surgical procedure. It also helps us to determine the cause of the hearing loss, whether the middle ear is involved for the hearing loss or not. So it differentiates between conductive hearing loss and sensory neural hearing loss. These are the few clinical applications of tympanometry. Revising the video lecture, there are various types of tympanograms depending upon the middle ear pressure as well as the mobility of the tympanic membrane. The common types are A, B and C. A type tympanogram indicates normal middle ear function. So middle ear pressure will be normal limits and the movement of the tympanic membrane, the complaints of the tympanic membrane will be within the normal limits. If the movement of the tympanic membrane is restricted but the middle ear pressure is within normal limits, then it will result in type AS tympanogram, mostly seen in otosclerosis or tympanosclerosis. If the movement of the tympanic membrane is extremely high, higher complaints, then it will result in AD type tympanogram. However, the middle ear pressure will be within normal limits. This is seen in ossicular chain discontinuity, thin or flaccid tympanic membrane. B type tympanogram is seen in three conditions. Flat tympanogram with normal ear canal volume indicates the person is having middle ear effusion. Flat tympanogram with large ear canal volume indicates the person has perforated tympanic membrane. Flat type tympanogram with reduced ear canal volume indicates there is some kind of obstruction in the ear canal, mostly impacted cerumen. C type tympanogram indicates eustachian tube dysfunction where the peak pressure is shifted towards negative side, indicating the middle ear pressure is negative in nature. These are the references for this particular video lecture. Thank you.